Hello everybody, 大家好，我是 Emily， 欢迎来到我的频道。职场中大家是不是有时候觉得自己的英语太普通，不够有气势力度？今天我们来说说几个职场当中常常用到的 power verbs, strong verbs,高级动词，这些动词呢能够帮助我们 sound more professional and powerful. They can help us perfectly express our ideas and opinions and say exactly what we want to say. 我们在会议当中，在写报告，在写总结的时候，用上这些动词可以帮我们 power up 我们的英语表达，提升我们的职业形象。如果你喜欢我的内容，别忘了点赞订阅，点击这个小铃铛，这样我一发视频你就会收到通知了。第一个 modify, meaning to change something slightly, to improve it, or make it more acceptable. 就是指稍作修改、更改的意思，强调产生细小变化的修改。那么跟它相近意思的 change 这个动词，这也是改变的意思，但是它强调的是与原先的情况有明显不同的大的改变。职场中我们要表达稍稍修改一下，用 modify 会更加专业一些。比如Can you please modify the project management plan for me? Can you please modify the project management plan for me? 你能帮我修改一下项目管理计划书吗？ The HR manager did agree to modify their recruitment policy. The HR manager did agree to modify their recruitment policy. 人力资源经理确实同意修改他们的招聘政策。HR 这个缩写代表 Human Resources, 人力资源部的意思。Modification 是 modify 的名词形式。比如说 ,a cup of modifications and the speech will be perfect. A cup of modifications and the speech will be perfect. 只要稍加修改这篇演讲稿就完美无缺了。下一个词 expedite.Meaning to make something happen more quickly, 促进加快的意思。职场中我们常常用这个词代替 accelerate 和 speed up。比如说 expedite the process, 加快流程。Something needs to be done to expedite the process. Something needs to be done to expedite the process. 需要采取措施以加快流程。We appreciate whatever you are able to do in order to help expedite shipment.我们感谢你能尽力帮助加快发货。那么 expediter 就是指 someone who speeds up a process or completion of a project。这也是一个 job title， 是一个职位，是一个 position found within project management, construction, purchasing, and production control。指的是 a person who expedites, who is employed to ensure the steady progress to completion of a project.我这个词还真的，我查了一下，是中文翻成督查员啊。这个职位呢，在物流、采买、工程项目当中很常见。下一个 define, meaning to explain something more clearly, 定义、界定、确定的意思。比如说 ，When preparing presentation, first define your goals. When preparing presentation, first define your goals.准备演讲稿的时候，首先要定义你的目标是什么。The first step is to define the scope of work. The first step is to define the scope of work. 第一步是定义工作范围。Roles and responsibilities should be clearly defined in the workplace to help improve operational performance. Roles and responsibilities should be clearly defined in the workplace to help improve operational performance.职场中应该明确定义角色和职责，以帮助改善运营绩效。下一个 leverage, meaning to get as much advantage or profit as possible from something you have. 利用什么什么获得好处，利用什么什么获利。Leverage 本意是杠杆的意思，金融行业呢只利用杠杆来获利。这个词已经普遍被用在各个商业领域，意思是使用、利用的意思。比如说 ,She was able to leverage her travel experience and her gift for languages to get a job as a translator. She was able to leverage her travel experience and her gift for languages to get a job as a translator. 她能够利用自己的旅行经历和语言天赋来获得这个翻译的工作。We can gain market advantage by leveraging our network of partners. We can gain market advantage by leveraging our network of partners. 我们可以利用合伙人获得市场优势。下一个 identify. Identify meaning to recognize a problem. 发现找出问题，职场中只确定那些潜藏的问题和风险。比如说KPIs are the best sources to use in order to identify skill gaps. KPIs are the best sources to use in order to identify skill gaps. KPI 是用于找出职业技能差距的最佳渠道。那么这个 KPI 是一个很常见的缩写 Key Performance Indicator 的意思，关键绩效指标的意思。Was he able to identify any risks of this project? Was he able to identify any risks of this project?他是否能够找出这个项目的任何风险呢？下一个 engage， engage 意思是 to become involved actively or have contact with somebody or something， 是谁谁谁参与与谁谁谁建立密切的联系。我们知道这个词动词也有订婚的意思，但是在职场中呢，它是指从事参与什么什么我们可以用 engage somebody in something 这个表达。比如说 I'm currently engaged in several engineering projects. I'm currently engaged in several engineering projects. 我目前从事几个工程项目。 It is extremely important for the project success to get key client team members truly engaged in the project activities as early as possible. It is extremely important for the project success to get key client team members truly engaged in the project activities as early as possible. 尽早让关键的客户团队成员真正的参与项目活动，对于项目的成功而言至关重要。 Companies that engage their customers via social media have more loyal customers. Companies that engage their customers via social media have more loyal customers. 通过社交媒体与顾客保持紧密联系的公司拥有更多的忠实顾客。最后一个 involve， involve meaning to include someone in something or to make them take part in something， 把某人包含到某事当中来，让某人参与某事。这个词和我们刚刚说的 engage 的用法和意思很相似，它们主要的区别是 involve in some activity 指的是 a person performs it because he's asked to， 别人要他做这件事，参与的程度不大。Engage in the same activity 就是指这个 person does it because he's truly interested in doing this work to achieve the desired results. 他自己很感兴趣，愿意从事这件事，积极参与的意思。比如说 ,we would involve members from purchasing team as well. We would involve members of purchasing team as well. 我们也将请采购团队的成员参与。I'm involved in several shale gas projects. I'm involved in several shale gas projects. 我参与了几个页岩油气项目。好，今天的内容就是这些。如果你喜欢的话，别忘了点赞和订阅，也可以在下面留言里告诉我你想要学习的话题。Until next time, bye.